round two of 3 minute thesis competition. Our third speaker is Zheng from the Department of Psychology. She will be talking about how do we understand foreign accents.
Okay, so first of all, I would like to ask you for a favor. Please just repeat after me. Yi.
Yi.
Thank you very much. My name is Yi, and I study psychology of language. Just now, everyone in this room said my name, Yi. But let's admit it, we all said it differently. Different emotions, different tones, different accents, etc. However, no matter how you said it, I had no problem understanding you. You might say, well, what's so surprising about that? Let's think about it this way. Nowadays, we have our machines like Siri or Alexa to understand human language, but how many times we said something and they totally misunderstood us? Super annoying, right? Speaking and understanding language is such a simple and spontaneous thing for us, but even the most sophisticated machine today still cannot be as good as we are. So in my PhD, I study how people process natural language, and specifically, my dissertation is asking a challenging question. How do we understand foreign accents? Just like the person in the picture, when we first meet someone who speaks with a very heavy accent, we hardly understand anything. But after a while, we understand better. Why? This is what we think that happens. So just think about two sounds. Let's say a T sound and a D sound, and we have some ambiguous sounds in the middle generated by the computer. So just like a black to white color spectrum, sounds in the middle are just like different shades of the gray, dark gray, light gray, etc. What's interesting is that although the sounds are changing continuously, our brain does something totally different. So we hear T, 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 and boom, it changes to D. The place where we experience this sudden change is what we call the phonetic category boundary. So this actually makes a lot of sense because in the real world, if you hear someone saying, I want a tie, you don't want to hear it as, I want to die. Whether it's T or D, it makes a huge difference, and that's what the boundary is for. So, but when we're listening to accent, actually a lot of sounds are going to be in this gray zone. So a person might be saying sounds D, not like that, maybe here. So what's remarkable about this boundary is that it can move around. And we think that the flexibility of this boundary moving around is one of the major reasons why this person's question marks disappear after listening to accent for a while. So it is my hope that one day, not only us, but our machines like Siri or Alexa can understand your accent, my accent, better as well. Thank you.